guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Lisa, and in today's video, I'm going to be going through how I stack my rings, and this is kind of a part two video because I've already made one video in the past. It was about 2 years ago, and that video was back when my entire collection was silver, and all the rings that I had used from that video were all from Pandora, but I've updated my collection a lot since, and also all my jewelry since then has now been converted to gold, as you guys can see, and all of them are honestly all from Majuri. Because of this updated collection, I wanted to do an updated video on how I stack my rings, and that way you guys are able to see in case you have also updated your collection to gold, or if your current collection is gold, you can kind of see some of the items that I have, and maybe it will inspire you for your collection. So if you guys watched my last video, you guys will know that one of the things about my hands is this is actually something that I'm super self-conscious about because of a few reasons. Number one, I just always feel like I have really short and stubby hands. That's why I kind of like to bling out my hands just to kind of distract myself and others from looking at what my hands truly look like. Anyway, I know I'm being dramatic, but I truly do feel vulnerable about my own hands. The other thing is that I feel like I also have really short nail beds, so that's why I really like to get my nails done as well. And on top of that, just to make everything better, the back of my hands have a little bit of eczema, especially come the winter time. So all in all, this is kind of why the reason I love blinging out my hands, because these are kind of just the things that I do. When I look at my hands, it makes me feel so, so, so much better. I just feel like that's kind of the reason I kind of started this channel also, is because, you know, we all have areas that we're a little bit insecure about, but we want to be able to enhance how we feel about it, and you can kind of just do it by, you know, accessorizing or doing other self-love tactics to help you kind of feel better. Anyway, this is just one of the things that I love to do and I want to share with you guys, because obviously everyone has their own insecurities, so I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about mine as well. But anyway, without taking away from the video, let's get started on the ring stacking. So the first thing I wanted to talk about before I go into each individual ring is a couple of things. Number one, when you're purchasing rings, there's a few things that you should consider. When it comes to buying gold rings, you should consider whether or not you want to buy gold vermeil or solid gold. And if you have seen my previous current Majuri favorites, I have two of them, which you guys can watch. You guys will know the difference is basically gold vermeil is just gold coating. You guys will know that with gold vermeil, you have to take it off when you shower. You basically only put it on when you're about to leave to go out for the day. But with solid gold, you can keep your rings on the entirety of the day. And I think that this is a very important thing to consider before you purchase, because number one, you want to know whether or not the price point is worth buying for. So solid gold, since you can keep it on at all times, the price point is going to be a lot higher. So I think that in the very beginning, you need to understand whether or not you are someone that likes to keep their rings on or wants to take them off at the end of each night. If you think that you're going to be someone who's going to be taking their rings off at the end of each night anyway, or even before you shower, I feel like there almost isn't really a reason to have to go pay for solid gold. But personally, I absolutely hate having to take off my rings and put it on. So I actually have converted all of my collection to pretty much solid gold. So everything that I'm wearing today is solid gold. The only ones that are not solid gold are two of the rings that I actually coincidentally forgot to bring to Vancouver, because like I said, I'm such a low maintenance jewelry person and I just like to keep everything on hand. So if I forget in the mornings because I'm in a rush, that's kind of why I don't prefer gold vermeil, only because I'm a really forgetful person and I like to just keep everything on my body at all times. That's also why I kind of forgot the two items, because when I was rushing to the airport, I didn't put the two rings on. So there's that. Make sure you distinguish between what type of person you are, what type of wearer you are. If you are going to take it off, maybe just consider gold vermeil. If not, you can go for the solid gold gold option. So a lot of these rings that I have here today actually come in the gold vermeil option. So you don't have to potentially pay for the price point. And we're gonna go into that when I go into the each individual ring. The second thing that I think is super important to consider is having a very, very good understanding of your ring size. I feel like with both of my hands, my sizes are pretty similar. So I only have really like three sizes on my hand. I have size 6, which is my thumb, my index finger, my middle finger. And then the two other sizes are size 5 for my ring finger. And I guess my pinky would be like a size 3 maybe. I don't know. Sometimes it alternates, I guess, per season. Sometimes your fingers will expand or contract. It kind of alternates the sizes. But for me, the last two fingers are either between like a 3, 4, or a 5. The reason why this is important is because when I buy some of my rings, the most worn fingers that I alternate between are these three, my thumb, my index finger, and my middle finger. Usually when I buy a ring, I will almost always buy a size 6 because I know I can alternate between these three fingers. However, if I know that it is a ring that I'm specifically only wearing for my ring finger or my pinky, that's when I'll really, really consider sizing down. And once again, this is important because everyone's hands are different. You could have all different sizes for every single one of your fingers. You could have the same size for all of your fingers, which makes it super versatile. But for the people who have variations of sizes, this is when you should really, really consider, if I buy this ring and it's only for that one size, for that one finger, then you should be pretty committed to that one finger that you purchase. But if you are someone like me who has pretty flexible sizes sometimes, then it kind of opens up the possibility of switching around. So that being said, I'm gonna dive into my stacks and kind of how I stack my rings and how I choose my rings. So I'm gonna start with my left hand. So this is pretty much kind of like how my left hand looks like. So starting with my thumb, the ring that I have for my thumb is the beaded ring, and this is what it looks like. And with this ring, this is pretty much the gold equivalent to the beaded ring that I have from Pandora that I absolutely loved, and I loved it as a thumb ring. I just absolutely love having something super dainty, and I just love the beads for the thumb. I also shared this in one of my past videos. A little test that I like to do is I like to put it on my hand and kind of like shake my hand aggressively. Oh no. And shake my hand aggressively just to see whether or not the rings will come off, because that will help me feel secure whether or not if I can continue putting a ring on that finger, and if I go out, it I guess give me the confidence that it will not fall off in the middle of the day. For this one, I also did the shake test. It passed it, so I'm pretty confident that this one is pretty good for my thumb. And like I said, this one I have it in a size 6. The next ring that I have is on my index finger, and this one is the bold stacker. And I honestly think that both of the rings I'm mentioning so far are must-haves. It's just a classic band that honestly is going to be able to go with anything in your collection. You want to be able to pick pieces that are able to be stackable. So a lot of the ones that are easily stackable are the ones that are universally all around the entire band looks the same. So the beaded one pretty much just looks the same throughout, except for the very end. There's like a little band thing, but it doesn't really take away that much. The second one is the bold stacker. It is the same the entire way around. So it's really, really easy to stack. And I will show you guys in the next finger what I mean by how some of them is a little bit different. So in my index finger right now, I have the gold pave diamond ring stacked with the solo diamond ring. And as you guys can see, this is what I mean by the entirety of the ring is not the same, because you have this design on one side and this side is just the ring part. These more unique designs, I feel like it's easier to stack it with these more basic rings around. But in this case, I actually stacked both the diamond pieces together, and it does actually still look super nice and super cute. So that's kind of what the two looks like. And honestly, I've just been loving all of Mejuri's diamond stuff. So I won't go into it, but I have their like diamond earring. I have one of their threaders, and I do have a couple other diamond pieces on the other hand that I will show you. So the next ring that I got is the mini signet ring with the initial. And this is actually meant for your pinky. It also has my little initial on it. But the thing is, this one did not pass the shake test because if I shake my hand really aggressively, it will fly off of my pinky. So for the sake of this video, I put it on my pinky because this is what I intended the ring to do. This is what I wanted it to look like initially. However, because it falls off so easily, I end up wearing it just on my ring finger sometimes so it won't fall off. This one is in, I believe, a size 4, and I think I should have gotten a size 3 for the sake of my pinky, but it's fine because I actually just wear it on my ring finger when I go out and when I'm not at home to prevent it from falling off. But I do think that it does look amazing on the pinky just like that. It's just super dainty and it has your initial on it, so that's kind of what this one looks like. So on the next hand, I have the Charlotte ring in solid gold. So this is what the ring looks like. This ring also comes in the gold vermeil option. So if you wanted the gold vermeil option, you totally can try the gold vermeil option. This is my statement ring in solid gold. I also have the croissant ring in gold vermeil, and I also have the boyfriend stacker in the gold vermeil. And those are usually the ones that I will wear here or here on either one of these fingers, but I'll put it on just at the start of the day and take it off at the end of the day. But like I said, I forgot the two rings back in Toronto, so I cannot show you guys. But those two are two of my favorite gold vermeil pieces. So if you guys love the look, you can get the boyfriend stacker in gold vermeil, and you can also get the croissant in gold vermeil. They also have the solid gold options for both of them. So there's a solid gold croissant ring, and I believe the stacker for the boyfriend one in solid gold is honestly just this ring here, which is a lot thinner than the boyfriend stacker. The last finger that I wanted to show you guys is another two diamond pieces. So this is what the diamond pieces look like. This one is the new dome ring, and this one's also in all diamonds, and this one is a little bit pricey, but I just love, 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 love the look of it. And I'm gonna show you the difference between the diamond piece and the pave piece. This is kind of what the difference looks like. So the diamond dome ring actually sticks up, and I feel like it has a whiter look, whereas the pave, it's a little bit flatter, and it kind of comes in a different shape as well. So if you guys want to see the difference, this is kind of what it looks like, but I just absolutely love both of my diamond pieces. They're just so gorgeous, and I also don't have a diamond engagement ring, so you know what? I'm gonna buy myself my own diamonds, and I don't need no man to get no diamonds, okay? So the next piece that I linked it up with is the opened diamond ring here. And this one is also super cute. I got both of these sizes, like I said, specifically for my ring finger because that's the only finger that is that size. So I had to really make a decision that that was the size that I was gonna get. But I did realize that with this piece, because it's open-ended, a few interesting things. Number one, you can kind of adjust the size to your liking, kind of pull it a little bit, not too hard, to adjust it if you really, really want to put it on a different finger. The second thing is that it gets caught a lot because of that little hole. It can get caught through like your clothes or whatever, just like in between. But I just love, love, love the look of this one. It just looks a little bit open and stuff like that. So I just think that one is super cute as well. So anyway, before I go into the wish list items, I just wanted to say that I think the trick to stacking rings is really getting more basic pieces. If you are gonna get more statement pieces, I do find that it looks better on its own. So like this one I consider like a really big statement piece, or even if you are gonna get statement pieces that are like this but they're a little bit thinner, I would pair it with rings that are a little bit more dainty. That way it counterbalances the statement. You're still drawing your eye to the statement pieces. For example, if I put this ring with, I don't know, like one of the other rings like this, it just doesn't look as great to my eyes, like because you just have too much going on here. So I personally like to either stack a more statement ring with a very, very basic ring, or just wear the statement rings on its own. And that way you can kind of like maximize the way that you are stacking your rings and the way that your eyes are appealing to the ring. And like I said, sizing is a huge factor because it really determines which ring can go where and how you can kind of change everything around. This is the way I've just been stacking my rings recently. Hopefully you guys were able to find some sort of inspiration to some of these rings, or some of the combinations that I've made up. With that being said, I am gonna kind of go through some of Mejuri's new rings or existing ones that are on my wish list, or the ones that I think that are gonna be pretty good to add to your collection in terms of stacking. So one of the rings that I have been eyeing on for so long, but it keeps on selling out, is the thin chain ring. It's funny because when I look at it online, it first didn't really appeal to me because I'm like, this looks like it's gonna fall off really easily, and it just didn't look even that great. But then I saw someone wearing it in person one time and I was like, oh my god, wait, is that the Mejuri thin chain ring? And she's like, yes, and it looks amazing. So she totally inspired me and I'm definitely gonna get that ring next time. But it looks super dainty and it looks super like malleable. It doesn't look very structured, so it has such a unique take to it. So if you guys are looking for like kind of a unique solid gold piece, that one I think is super super cute. The other ring that I absolutely have always loved is the thin dome ring, but because the diamond one came out, I wanted to get the diamond one instead. The thin dome ring I've actually had on my wish list for so long, and also one of my best friends has it, and it's actually super light. It's very hollow on the inside and it's just such a great solid gold piece. So I think that one's a really good alternative to the diamond one in case you guys don't love the diamond, or if the price point for this one is quite big. So the alternative, I would definitely recommend the thin dome one because it's just so beautiful. The next few rings that I think that are super great for stacking are the stacker ring, which is actually their cheaper price point solid gold ring. It's at $95 Canadian. The other one is the twist ring. These are all very, very basic ones, and I also think those could be really great thumb rings as well in case you don't like the beadedness. There's also some other just like very dainty ones throughout, like the diamond line ring. That one's also really good. I think I might add that one to my collection as well. But there's just a few rings here that are just super, super dainty and have very little minimal design. Even the dot ring, that one's super nice. Another one that I think I'm gonna order is the metallic sphere ring, and that one's in gold vermeil. I love how stacked the dots are on top of the actual ring. So that one's super cute. And then lastly, this one's actually been on my wish list since the very first Mejuri video, but it's the duo ring. So the duo ring is actually so unique because it actually has two rings and it's like linked in between. So when you wear it together, it almost stacks for you already. And it just has that really interesting crisscross that I've just had my eye on for so long. So that's definitely on my wish list. But as you guys can see, I am just very addicted to their jewelry. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, got some inspo, and if you guys have any more questions, feel free to leave it down in the comment section down below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!